Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for stopping by today for Message from Spirit. As you know, I'm Jaylene. Super excited that you're here today because I've had someone kind of bother me pretty much all day, and I was kind of excited to get home and rush back here so that I can get in front of the camera and just record it so that I can get a little bit of peace of mind. I'm going to be honest. This male here is quite insistent, and the thing is, he's more and more descriptive, and I'm kind of glad that I waited to do the video because I got more and more of a sense of a dad wanting to give a daughter a message. Now, the thing is, he was very, very adamant about a December 9th date, and so that's in 5 days from now. I don't even know what date that falls on, but if I were to look at the calendar here, December 9th, happens to fall on next Tuesday. And so he makes me feel that there's some kind of celebration on that day. So I don't know if it's a birthday. I don't know if it's like someone got a new job or if someone got a loan and bought a house, but there's some kind of marked celebration for the 9th of December. And I don't think it's a date of passing at all. I really honestly feel so excited about December 9th. Now they make me feel, this male that's passed, no more than 59 years old. So I'd say between 55 to 59 years of age, a little bit heavier set, you know, or a little bit of a bigger man. I'd say about 6 foot, 6 foot one, but he just makes me feel he had a little bit of meat to go with his potatoes. So in other words, he makes me feel that he had a little bit of a paunch, you know, a little bit of a tummy or a little bit of love handles. He did actually, make me feel that he passed of lung cancer. Very clearly, the lungs look black to me. But he makes me almost get the sense that it took a long time for him to pass from that. So if he would have had lung cancer, he could have lasted a year and a half to 2 years. Now, this male does not give me his name, but he gives me details about himself as to the heavy set type of person, little bit dark, wavy hair. I think almost like it could even be to a black color. Skin doesn't look olivey, it looks quite fair. So I wouldn't know what nationality he is. He did tell me that he had lung cancer from smoking or being exposed to a lot of smoke, and that he had himself quit maybe 5 to 6 years before he became sick or was diagnosed with lung cancer. And so, you know, from the time he passed, because he gives me, you know, the feeling that he lasted about a year and a half or so. So he could have quit maybe seven and a half years before passing. He tells me that he has a daughter, and he only gives me the feeling to one child for him, unless there was, you know, a stepchild. I honestly don't get that feeling of any other children involved, but he gives me either an Amanda or an Amelia or an Adele or an Amy name, but it starts with the letter A. It could be Angela, Angelique, you know, that kind of thing. But he makes me feel very close to this daughter, and I don't know if this daughter was only 27 or 28 when he passed away, but that's maybe probably late 20s, but that's how he makes me feel, that this girl was a little bit in her later 20s. He says that she wasn't there when he passed away. He makes me, you know, look at a clock that gives me about 4:30, 5 o'clock a.m. because it's still dark and I don't get the sense of a winter month with this. But he does tell me that he passes early morning before the nurse comes in. And I do feel him comfortable. I do feel him like very, very drugged up. So I don't get the sense that he struggled with his passing or that it was difficult at all. He does really insist that he wanted to be on his own when he passed. So if his daughter has any type of guilt for not being there or not getting there in time, because I think she got there at 7:30. From what I understand, I would just put that aside because he wanted to pass on his own. Everybody always dies the way they're intended to. And so if someone's not in a room or they've just left to go for supper or they've just gone somewhere else, it's because that spirit really didn't want them there. Now, this man also tells me that he had two brothers and one sister. He doesn't make me feel that the brothers were like living in town. He makes me feel that both brothers lived out of town to him, but I feel that his sister lived close by. They talk about the hospital or the hospital that was close by the house. So I don't know if there was a clinic or a hospital very close by or a medical kind of office, within walking distance from this man that's talking to me, but he makes me feel that they live close to the hospital, or the hospital wasn't really that far away. He does talk about the brothers or the two brothers that live out of town. I would feel that I'd have to go eastwards with that. And so if you're living in BC, we're going east all the way. It could even be as far as Nova Scotia, or it could be just 2 hours away. But out of town for me personally is always a 2 hour drive or more. And so he gives me the feeling that his brothers lived a couple hours away from where he lived, but he still kept in touch with them. One of the brothers, and I don't know if it's like a Roger or a Roy or a Ross, like an R and an O in the name, or Raymond, that kind of thing. He just makes me feel that that brother really has difficulties with his passing because they were fairly close or had been through some very close personal experiences together. Now for this female, Amanda or Amy or Amelia or Angel or whoever you are, I hope you get this message, but your dad wants you to know that his lungs don't hurt anymore and his back is fine. He's not upset with the doctor anymore. I think he was upset because he had complained about his back being sore, but nobody really picked it up as being lung cancer for maybe 2 or 3 years. So he was a little ticked off because he was too far advanced, but he did last a good year, year and a half, 2 years. So he makes me feel he lived that through pretty good. He's really happy to have seen his dad. His dad had died 22 or 23 years, 20 plus years just the same. So he hadn't seen his father in a long time, but he makes me feel his mom is still here, quite elderly or older, okay? And he does make me feel that she has had difficulties with his passing. So I do get the sense this male passed maybe within the last couple of years. And I'm hoping that you can make sense of this. If you know who this is, please share this with all of your friends and your family. And I was going to give you some updates, but I just wanted to simply give you the message from Spirit. I will be doing some updates for you all about the booking calendar, all those wonderful things today, but please get this message out. Someone needs to know that someone's happy on the other side. They need to know that he's not suffering anymore, and that he really comes around his daughter a lot. He congratulates her. And December 9th, for some reason, yay, big celebrations. And it's this December 9th. So I hope you can relate. Have a beautiful day. Share away. And we'll talk to you real soon with another message from Spirit. Take care. Bye-bye.